get up in the morning slaving for bread, sir, so that every mouth can be fed. Oh, me Israelite, sir. Get up in the morning slaving for bread, sir, so that every mouth can be fed.
Oh, yes.
All right, we are the Hebrew Israelites.
Yeah, come.
Okay, we come week in and week out to prophesy the downfall of the society,
right,
and to bring out the truth,
right.
And first and foremost, we want to give all praises to our Lord and Savior Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai.
Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai.
Double honors to the apostles of GMS.
Right.
The Lord set up to teach this truth with sincerity.
Right.
All right. Special salutations to the Akarah Kal Kahan.
Come
here with us in spirit.
Right.
All right. And salutations to you, Akim, that's pushing out this truth across the four winds, man.
That's right.
All right. So, hey, man. Y'all basically had your weekend celebration of a tradition of men known as Thanksgiving. You know, and pretty much we're going to bring out the truth of the matter of this whole Thanksgiving, you know. And first off, we're going to start out talking about the y'all all into this new world order. But we got to understand what's the word a new world first came from. All right. But first, let's start off with this Isaiah 65. Right. Thanks for stealing and thanks for killing.
Yeah, that's what should be called.
Right.
Thanks for stealing and thanks for killing, man.
Right.
No?
This is the book of Isaiah, chapter 65, verse 11.
Right.
But ye are they that forsake the Lord, that forget my holy mountains.
Right.
And who are the ones that forsaking the Lord? Who are they that forsake? Is you Jakes, man. You Israelite. You two-thirds. You know?
Right. Y'all forsake the Lord. The two-thirds forsake the Lord by having these different holidays and celebrations. And which is a tradition done after men.
Right.
Because back then, let's just be explain even the matter, they wasn't even really eating turkeys back then. A good dish would be a good venison. All right, which would be like a deer. You understand? So now it's a turkey. Now it's stuffing. Now it's yams. That's a tradition of men.
Now,
right.
Now it's ham.
Ham.
Hey, Brother Shaquad, give me Amos 5 and 21. Hold on to that.
Yo, I know this is said, y'all forsake the holy mountain. Now the mountain, that word goes back to government.
That's right.
Which means to govern your minds.
Come on.
Which means you abandon the ways that the Bible tells you to move.
Yeah, you abandon the government of Yahweh and Yahweh Shai.
Right.
Right.
Continuing. That prepare a table for that truth.
Right, with a food sign at. Right, y'all prepare a table. Y'all prepare a table of abomination, man.
God!
Because these scriptures is just talking about what y'all do.
God.
It was prophecy for y'all to do this, man.
Right.
So the Lord was saying that prepare an abomination. You know, because you got your ham there. You got your shellfish. You know? Okay?
You got your chitlins. They be having chitlins and ham. Ham with the pineapple.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? What else they be having? A lot of shrimp.
Come.
You know what I'm saying? All manner of the stuffing. They be putting pork in it, man.
Right.
All manner of wickedness, man.
Right.
And that's why you see in our community, especially the Black and Latino Native American community, we got high rates of blood pressure.
Come.
You know, everything is messed up in our community, man.
Right.
We under some of the worst health conditions ever known to man.
Right.
And because of the stuff that we eat, man.
Right.
You know? And Thanksgiving, or thanks for stealing, you know, that's a day that you see the reason why people, they be having the triple neck, you know, that extra meat on their arm.
Right. Huh?
Like a turkey.
You know, they look exactly like a turkey, man.
Right.
And Jake.
Muffin top.
Yeah,
we
have
a
little muffin top
belly
right here.
Having them rolls, man.
Right.
You see it?
Right.
You got cities
on your back.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
Because
they eating all that, you know, abominable food, man.
Right.
Pork.
You got your aunt coming over. She can't even breathe. She.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. You know, right. Eating all that damn wickedness, man.
Come.
You know. Yeah. And when you read the Leviticus the 11th chapter. We ain't gonna sit out here and read it, but it gives you the dietary law, man.
Right.
You know? Yeah.
I just want to add, it says here that prepare a table for that troop. Now you gotta ask yourself, what you preparing the table for, like who that troop are. And
right.
Here it is, you have this Thanksgiving dinner and you're preparing all this these foods and you don't know what you're preparing it for.
Right.
Yeah. And this troop is talking about the Gadites, man. You are so-called Native Americans, you know, that were slaughtered, you know, by the Europeans that came to your land and stole your land, and that's what you're preparing the food for. So
right.
You gotta ask yourself, you know, who those troops are. Now, I have a precept. I'm gonna go to Genesis 49,
God.
Verse 19.
That's right.
Gad, talking about so-called Native Americans,
right.
A troop shall overcome him.
Right, that troop. It's who y'all prepared table for.
Right.
Since when do you celebrate your downfall, man?
That's
who prepares
right.
A table for somebody kicking their butt, man?
Right. That's like if you had a daughter and your daughter got raped. Your daughter got raped and then you throw a yearly festival.
Right.
Bigging up the dude that raped your daughter, man.
Right.
You your daughter got raped and every year you throw a yearly festival on your daughter getting raped, man.
Right.
And you bigging up the dude that raped your daughter, man.
Right.
That's how stupid our people are, man.
God.
These people done raped your daughters and y'all doing damn celebrations for it, man.
That's right.
Damn idiots, man. Yeah.
And you see any even more how you know who the troop is, because down in North Dakota, you got the same troop oppressing the same people that y'all doing this Thanksgiving for, man.
God.
All right, they shooting them in their heads with rubber bullets. They spraying them down, giving them hypothermia with water hose.
Yeah.
Protesters at the Dakota Access Pipeline continue to be met with insane violence, and our very own Jordan Cheriton reports and shows us exactly what they're dealing with. Take a look.
So where you're seeing the police, whether it's state police, DAPL security, they're on top of a giant mountain that is where their ancestors are buried, the Native Americans.
The Natives want to go and hold a peaceful prayer circle on the other bank. This is land that is theirs per the Laramie Treaty of 1851. This is a sacred burial site. But also, they're saying it's Army Corps of Engineer lands, which means on multiple levels what's happening here is illegal. This is a militarized police force up against an unarmed, peaceful prayer for people.
So I was out there, one of the first ones in the water. Maced us, it hurts.
I feel like I'm watching the salt mine protest with Gandhi. I mean, these people are in the water. They're freezing to death. This water is not warm. I couldn't feel my legs. I had to get out or I was about to pass out.
They're trying to disperse women and children because there's a fear that the cops that are coming in on those boats over there have actual bullets.
The police are committing genocide!
I see a sniper laying right there on the ridge. You can see his rifle sticking over the edge of the ridge right there. The sniper is not holding rubber bullets, I guarantee you.
The temperature is so cold out there, right? They spraying them with the water and the people catch a hypothermia.
Right.
They throwing concussion grenades at them, man.
Right.
You know, yesterday they locked up 100 of them at the mall, man.
Right.
You know? And the Native Americans dealt fair with you, man.
That's right. Yeah.
And that's the payment that they get back, man.
That's right.
You know? That's because you wicked, man.
That's right.
Right. Yeah.
All right, finishing off Genesis 49, verse 19.
God.
But he shall overcome at the last.
Right. He shall. Oh, break this down.
Talking about the Gad in the latter days. Talking about
right.
The race war that they're gonna overcome you. You Esau.
Come.
You know.
Right.
You Edomites. That's right. You know. Lord's gonna put that spirit on him to overcome thee at the last.
That's
so
right.
It's gonna be all hell breaking loose during them race wars, man. It's gonna turn up.
Come. Right, man.
Come.
Right. The Most High is gonna put that old spirit back on him, man.
That's right.
Okay. The same spirit that them Pequot Indians that had on them, man. And that's what we gonna get into.
Yo.
I get a script? Okay, good.
Now, because when you look into the story,
mm-hmm.
When Esau came over to shake hands with them,
right.
They welcomed me with open arms.
Right.
But then
right.
What happened after that? You gave them diseases,
right.
You kill off a whole bunch of them, and
right.
Then after that, you got greedy and decided to enslave them, and then took their land.
That's right.
You know?
I got some.
Proverbs 3:31. Envy thou not the oppressor, and choose none of his ways.
Good.
Yeah, man. Good.
Right, man. It says, envy not thou thy oppressor, man.
Right.
How are y'all envying your oppressor, man? By doing the exact celebrations that they do, man. That these damn pilgrims and Puritans do, man. They're really the nation of Edom, and they're wicked, man.
Right.
And they show it by all of their actions all throughout the course of history, man.
Right. Choose none of their ways. So, hey, you could be on the job, and they might have a tradition that they do, and that tradition could be wicked. Right. Hey, just because you're on that job, you don't do that, man.
God.
You know?
God.
Hey, just because you're in America, hey, you know that saying, when in Rome, you do what the Romans do?
Right, God.
Well, guess what? We don't do what the Romans do wickedly, man.
That's right.
Right. Yeah, we pay our taxes because we don't have no choice to pay taxes, man.
God.
But, yo, you don't have to celebrate Thanksgiving.
Hey.
Right. You choose to do that, man.
That's right.
And you actually taking part of a ritual, man.
That's right.
With the cranberry sauces, the blood,
right.
The stuffing,
yeah.
The chicken,
yeah.
The turkey,
right.
You know? Those is rituals, man.
That's right.
You know? Go ahead.
Yeah, Psalms 55 and 20.
And then get to the article.
He hath put forth his hands against such as be at peace with him.
Right. He hath put forth his hands against such that be at peace with him, man. The Native American Indians. In the story that we're going to get, the man Squanto showed them how to exactly cultivate the land, how to eat, how to feed themselves, how to live. Matter of fact, they even helped them do the Louisiana Purchase. Okay? So they put forth their hands, and who is that person, man? Read verse 21.
This is verse 21.
Yeah, then you can
But you know what? You know what clowns are doing right now? They're doing the damn mannequin challenge. You got everybody on the damn internet doing the mannequin challenge.
Right.
You got everybody on the internet worrying about Kanye West going crazy. You know, all y'all dudes is caught up in the world, man.
Right.
You know?
Right.
Y'all all caught up in the world. Some damn Kanye, he going crazy, he got money.
Right.
Mm-hmm. This place about to be destroyed, man.
Hey!
Y'all in the time of destruction, man. And y'all dudes be out here walking around like y'all don't know what's going on, man.
Right.
Okay? Yeah.
Hey, you had a question, bro?
I'm Asian, so where do I fall in this?
You
gonna read a scripture for you real quick.
This is James 1 and 1, a servant of the Most High.
Right.
And the Lord Yahushua Mashiach.
Right.
To the 12 tribes which are scattered abroad.
These are the 12 tribes. They were scattered abroad. This is just something to formulate, you know what I'm saying, where most of us were scattered. Okay? Yeah, to give you an idea.
Right.
But we were scattered, it said, all over the world.
All over, bro. Scattered abroad. Thailand.
Right.
You got Israelites in Africa, you got Israelites all over, brother.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Hey, man, if you is against the society, you might as well be an Israelite, bro.
Right.
Because that's the spirit of the Lord, man.
Right.
To be against, that's what we're talking about right now.
Right.
Everybody out here celebrating Thanksgiving.
That's right.
You don't even know what it go back to, man.
Exactly.
You know?
Exactly. Yeah.
We got dudes out here that be smoking weed, trying to be rappers, man.
Right.
Like they don't know what's going on.
Later.
You know? Like you don't know you gotta sell your soul to get there, man.
Right, yeah, right. You gotta go.
That's why Kanye West going crazy.
Right. You gotta go to the tall dude, Leon Cohen. Huh. You know what I'm saying? Then Leon Cohen is behind the whole thing, man.
That's crazy.
All right. That's exactly what y'all dudes gotta do, man.
And the Lord gonna smoke his behind, man.
God.
You know?
Yeah. Give me that back.
Psalms 55, verse 20. He hath put forth his hands against such as be at peace with him.
Right. Right.
Which treaties was, with you?
Right. They did treaties. They showed you the land. You had the female, the name of Sacagawea, okay, who helped out with the Louisiana Purchase, Lewis and Clark, right? And you went and put forth your hand against them by putting them in reservations, man.
That's right.
And are oppressing them to this very day.
Right. He has broken his covenant.
Right. He has broken his covenant because they, give me that, in your article.
Go ahead.
Read that real quick with Abraham Lincoln.
Hey, this is an article, man. It says that over 500 treaties, man, has been broken by America, man.
God.
That they had with the so-called Native Americans, man.
God.
500, man.
God,
those are agreements that you made with their forefathers, man.
That's right.
And now you spraying water holes. You hitting them with concussion grenades, man.
God.
You know, you trying to shoot their drones down.
God.
Because you don't want the media to talk about it, man.
Right.
Okay? Go ahead.
Right. Got it. If not, just go back to yours. Go back to yours.
This is from identities of .mike.com. Six Native American girls explain the tragic story, what really happened to the Native Americans. This is in the year 1863, Abraham Lincoln issued a presidential proclamation to make Thanksgiving a national holiday.
Right.
Prior to the declaration, which set the holiday on the last Thursday of every November.
Right.
Thanksgiving was celebrated across all states on several different dates.
Right.
The intention, Thanksgiving was to establish a sense of unification between northern and southern states.
Right.
Since the country was in the midst of a civil war.
Mm-hmm.
However, the girls in the video explained, Lincoln ordered the execution of Native Americans. They mentioned the Dakota 38, the largest mass execution on U.S. soil.
Right.
Where 38 men from the Dakota tribe were murdered.
Yo.
They were hanged on December 26, 1862.
Right.
The day after Christmas.
Right. Right. So you northern tribes were getting hung the same way the southern tribe, Judah, the so-called Negroes, was being hung, man.
That's right.
Okay? And what it did is they passed one day for them to be doing these killings. Because the article that this brother going to bring out, they were doing Thanksgiving days every time they ran through a tribe, man.
Yeah.
They would do a feast. It was like when you beat somebody, you do a celebration. Like, yo, when you a basketball team, if they beat a team, they do like a celebration. That's what they were doing. They were beating the Native American Indians and doing Thanksgiving celebrations. And he just said, yo, we're going to do it once a year. But it was still an execution that was being done.
Right, it's still an execution, man. You know? And you had a dude by the Andrew Jackson. All right? He did the Trails of the Tears with General Winfield Scott. He went over there in northern Georgia and made the Cherokee Indians get out of Georgia, man. They made the Native Americans walk from Florida to Oklahoma, man.
Right.
You know? So this man is a devil, man.
Right.
And all he did was been oppressing people, man. He's still doing it, man.
Right.
But you got guys that don't want to snap out of it, man.
Right.
They caught up in this fashion. They caught up in this world, man.
Right.
You got to wake up and snap out of it, man.
That's right.
The Bible says hard times, man. We're in the time for you to wake up, man.
That's right.
Not for you to stay asleep, goddamn.
Right.
What's the wrong with you? Right. Yeah.
Back at Psalms 55, verse 21.
Right.
The words of his mouth were smoother than butter.
Right. See, the words of this man's mouth, it got to give you a characteristics of who this man is, man.
God.
Okay, so his mouth was smoother than butter. When you get into the story of Squanto, what the brother's going to do, he showed them how to basically live, man. It's like he pitied him. You know? Keep going.
But war was in his heart.
And how you know war was in his heart? Because they passed they passed this act called the Papal Bull. It was passed by Pope Nicholas V. He issues the Papal Bull, Dom de Veris. It says to reduce Muslims, pagans, and unbelievers to perpetual slavery. Okay? Those were acts that they pushed that was war, man. So their intention of coming there, which you're going to get the history of the New World, it was to conquer and take over, man.
That's right.
That's all it was. Yep. Keep going.
His words were softer than oil.
Right. Right.
Yet were they drawn swords.
Right, and we know they were drawn swords because they were killed. You got them in reservations now. And now you got them just fighting to have a water supply, man. Water is what people live off of, man.
Yeah,
it's key.
Right, that's life.
It's key.
Right.
Why does somebody have to fight and stand up for clean water, man?
God,
ain't no sense.
So you got all these oil spills going on,
right?
From Africa all the way down to North America, man. You know, all these oil spills going on, poisoning the land, you know, going to different countries, oppressing them, man, stealing people diamonds, stealing people gold, you know, and you don't think you're going to pay for that, man? You know? Hey, let me, y'all done? You done?
We got the article to read.
Alright,
this is from an article. The name is "The Real Story of Thanksgiving: Introduction for Teachers, the Potty Mouth Thanksgiving Story." Okay, it says most of us associated the holiday with happy pilgrims and Indians sitting down.
I used to watch the cartoon with the happy pilgrims.
Yeah,
they come up, and then the Indians come up. And they sit down and they have a big turkey dinner.
Con.
And you know what? And that's how you know this society is wicked, man.
Yeah.
Because when we was young, they taught us in school, how great Thanksgiving was, and you know how peaceful it was.
Yeah.
And then you get older, you realize that, you know, these people lied to you, man.
Yeah. Right.
You know? Why you got these people even teaching the kids for?
Right.
And they teaching them lies, man.
Exactly.
Yes.
Happy pilgrims and Indians sitting down to a big feast.
Right.
And that did happen once.
Right.
The story began in 1614.
Right.
When a band of English explorers sailed home to England with a ship full of Patchwork Indians.
Right. So these people, who are Edomites, grabbed a ship full of Indians. Okay, and they did what?
Patchwork Indians,
right,
bound for slavery.
They brought them into slavery, man.
What?
Keep going.
They left behind smallpox, which virtually wiped out those who had escaped.
Right, so they not only did they do that, they brought forth smallpox, man. They brought forth a disease that they have never, ever seen, man. You see the smallpox breaking out on them? They over here bugging out.
They had the smallpox blankets, man. And they was giving them the little babies, man.
Right.
You know? Yeah.
By the time pilgrims arrived in Massachusetts Bay,
right,
they found only one living Patois Indian.
Right, they only found one living Patois Indian, man. One living Patois Indian, man. And you think you can't pay for that, man? That's just supposed to be celebrated. We just supposed to go numb, and we just supposed to have a whole happy, jolly time with the family, man.
Yeah, God.
Nah, man, we gotta put this in stir up in remembrance.
Right. A man named Squanto.
Right, a man named Squanto.
Who had survived slavery in England.
Right.
And knew their language.
Right.
He taught them to grow corn and to fish.
Right.
And negotiate a peace treaty between the pilgrims and the Wampango Nation.
Right, and he got a little thing on smallpox.
Oh, look how smallpox look. That shit looks crazy.